We had the debut of Andrade against Matt Sydal, and it was all right. I mean, there have been far better debuts. I thought the match would be better. I cannot figure out why Andrade is wrestling in dress pants. Like, what is that?
I couldn't figure it out. Now, Andrade, I thought, was okay. I'm watching this match, and it's like, this whole match is supposed to be the showcase for Andrade.
But it was for Sydal.
Sydal outworked
him. He was great.
Like crazy. Yeah, Matt Sydal was great.
Yes.
But it wasn't like they worked the match for Sydal to look good, and it was Andrade being unselfish. Not that he wasn't. I'm saying he was selfish, because he wasn't. But the match was worked in a way for both to look good, but only one of them looked good, because one of them was working his ass off, and it felt like the other one was like, I don't know. It's like, what I'm going to say is too strong, in the sense of, because there is sometimes there's the mentality that when you've been in WWE, I've seen it all the time, and I've talked to guys, you know, who explain the mentality to me. You know, it's like, when you've been to the show, you don't have to do all this stuff anymore because you're a star. The problem is that in this company, that attitude, you're not going to make it with that attitude. You're going to have to be hungry because everybody else is. And I'm not saying he did that, because he did some stuff. But I just thought that, he was good, sort of good, but he was not a standout. And certainly on this show, with all those guys that worked their ass off that were standouts, I mean, the one thing, he's got a good look and he's got a good body, but that's not enough in AEW at all. And if he wants to hang at the top level, he's going to be a lot better than he was in this match. And the match was fine because of Matt Sydal. It was actually a kind of good match. But I don't know. Yeah, I just thought Andrade was kind of there. That's all. I mean, he did some good stuff, but he wasn't that impressive.
They did the segment to hype up the Christian Matt Hardy match, which will take place at Fighter Fest Night 1.
Next Wednesday.
Yep, so there you go. And then they're in the ring, and Arn Anderson is there with Tony Schiavone, and he's talking about how great it is to be in Miami, and the fans are great, and he says, let's get the show on the road, and suddenly the lights go out, and earlier in the Cody match, the lights had gone out. And so the announcers are like, there's been some inclement weather and the power's gone.
That was, you know, because of the weather and everything, that actually was pretty cool to do it that way. Because it's like, usually when the lights go out, it's like, oh, God, somebody's debuting, right? But you know.
These people were excited for somebody debuting. Because when those lights turned on and it was the former Aleister Black, now Malakai Black.
Matt and Nick's brother.
They absolutely lost their minds. And he hit the black mass on Arn. He hit the black mass on Cody when he ran down. He laid them both out. Place went crazy, like this guy was a huge superstar. They put him over big. I mean, this was like,
this is great.
Five times better than anything they've done with Andrade so far. And this is a guy who was just missing off TV. It's funny, he was off TV forever, and then ultimately they did a bunch of vignettes that set him up for a debut here.
Yeah, because he's
that was
he's
nice of them.
It was nice of him because he's doing care. Well, why do you think they wanted him back? They figured that out. So the deal is, the 90 days are not up. He had an opt out at the 30-day mark. I don't know why he got that in or how he got it in, but he did. So that's the story. He had an opt out. Like, he could have taken the 90, but he was able to opt out at 30. And I think at that 30 was when we heard the stories of WWE really wants him back, because I think that they figured, oh my God, he could go. And he obviously had made this deal probably weeks ago, I'm guessing, because he signed the deal with Hayabusa Clothing Line, and as soon as he signed that deal, it's like he's got to be in AEW, because he could not take that deal if he was going to WWE, going back. So when he signed that sponsorship deal, that was pretty much of a sign that he's AEW bound for sure. And I know that the week that I wrote about him going to AEW, it was like, I don't know, a month ago or a little more, that it was pretty much like, I don't know if he had signed the paper, but it was pretty much like he had told people who were trying to book him, I think, that's what's happening. And then, WWE really wanted him back at that point. So he didn't go back. Or maybe he couldn't. Maybe by the time they made the offer, he had already committed. I don't know. But that's what happened.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts. And also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.